used to work a king of diamonds on a Monday. Only hit the club on Saturday and Sunday. I used to pull up every week, you should have seen her. The way she did it, nobody could do it cleaner. I seen her in a suit from her birthday. And I can tell you the reason these niggas thirsty. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today we are doing a tutorial using PicsArt to make a logo, a simple text-based logo. The first thing you're going to do is go to thefont.com. That is where you can download free fonts. So you're just going to go there and download all the fonts that you like. Once you find a font you like, you just click download. And then you're going to go up to the top right corner and click that little box with the arrow. And click on the font. Then you'll hold it in and you're going to click copy or share and then copy to PicsArt. PicsArt is the app that we're going to be using to make the logo. So you'll go to DaFont, you're going to download all the fonts that you want to use, and that way you can have them all ready. Then the next thing you're going to do is go to Google and download all the background and brush effects, glitter, everything like that that you want to use. So I know that I'm going to use a pink glitter, so I'm going to search for a pink glitter background and I'm going to click on images and I'm going to make sure that I click HD so that it has a high resolution and the quality is good. So I'm just going to find one that I like and I'm going to save that to my phone save that image to my phone. So you're just going to do that for all the different elements that you want to use in your logo. If you want to use silver glitter, gold glitter, shiny foil, whatever you want to use. So then we're going to come to the PicsArt app and you're just going to go all the way to the bottom. The background color that's at the bottom. So you're going to go all the way down to the bottom and you're going to choose the white background color. And you're just going to come up to the top and click apply and save. And you're going to just save that. You're not going to do anything to it. Then you're going to come back, go all the way back to the bottom again. And you're going to choose the first square, which is the checkerboard looking square. And that is that means that it's a transparent background. So we're going to choose that. Then we're going to go back into our photos. We're going to go to the bottom where it says add photo. Click that and you're going to choose that white box that you just saved and you're going to add that to your photo or to your logo. And we're going to stretch that over the canvas to size it so we can, it's just going to help us see everything better with the white background underneath. Now, do not click apply. That's very important. Do not click apply. Not yet. So now I'm going to go to the bottom and click add text and I'm just typing the word bliss. That's the name of my business. And you can play around with the color, the effects. You can do a gradient. You can choose your own color on the color wheel. Any, you know, mixture combination for a gradient effect. You can just play around with the settings and see what you like best. What I'm going to be doing is making the glitter letters. So to do that, I'm going to go to color and I'm going to click the little plus sign and like the little photograph box where it looks like to add picture, and I'm going to choose the pink glitter that I just saved to my phone, and that's going to give me the glitter effect inside my letters. So now I just need to choose a font that I like, and they have a couple of fonts already pre-installed on the app. On the free version, you'll notice there's a crown next to some of them. That means that that can only be used on the premium version, which is like $4.99 a month or something like that. You don't have to get that, but it is limited to your fonts if you don't get the premium version. There is also a 7-day free trial you can get. So that's what I did here. I just did the 7-day trial and made my logo so I didn't have to pay for anything. So I'm just going to play around with some of the fonts until I find what I like. But I'm just going to end up choosing one of the fonts that I downloaded from defont.com. This font is called Cointa. And I just like that font. I thought it was really pretty. So I'm going to choose that. And then I'm going to come and add a stroke. A stroke is like an outline. And you can choose the color of it that you want. You can choose the thickness, how thick or thin you want it. You can choose to use the color dropper and find a color like that matches the glitter on the inside, or you can use the color wheel and choose your own color, or you can use some of the color presets that they already have set up. So I kind of want like a gold outline, so I'm just going to play around until I find a color that I like. So I'm just going to use the one that's kind of already on the preset color wheel. Like I said, you can choose how thick or thin you want the stroke to be. That's all totally up to you. So I'm going to do mine pretty thin, right about here. This looks pretty good. And then I'm going to play around with the shadow. Now, when you add a shadow, that kind of gives it dimension and just makes it pop a little bit more. And I really like the look of that. So I'm going to go ahead and add my shadow. And you can also choose how opaque you want it to be. So it can be really dark or really light. You can choose the blur to be really intense or not. So I kind of want like a dark shadow, but less of a blur, just so it really, really pops and looks 3D. And I think that looks really nice. I know that I'm going to want some sort of a background on it, so I really want the letters to stand out. So that's why I'm doing my shadow this way. You don't have to do yours that way. You don't have to put a shadow at all. You can change the color of the shadow. It can be pink, green, purple, whatever color you choose. I'm just going to leave it at black for mine. And I'm just going to play around with it until it looks how I like it to look. So once I have it how I want it, then I'm going to add the next word in my logo, which is designs. Just going to click add text and type that out. And I need to change the color of it so I can see what I'm doing here. So I'm going to choose black. And of course, change the font. Now I want like a more simple font for this word, since the main word was kind of more fancy. And I decided I didn't like the look of the lowercase letter, so I'm going to make it all caps. So I'm just going to switch that real quick. And then I'm going to size it and position it to how I want it. And I don't want the letters so thin, so I'm going to add a stroke around these letters. Once again, that's the outline. And I think I'm going to go ahead and choose a pink outline for this one, one that matches the glitter inside the letters of the word bliss. So I'm going to use my color dropper to find a pink inside of there to do the outline with on this word. Like I said, you can use the color wheel and choose your own custom color, but like I said, I'm going to use the color dropper and choose one of the colors that's already inside the word. Then I'm going to add just a little bit of a shadow just to make it pop just a little bit, not too much. So this is all totally up to how you want it to look. Like I said, there is no right or wrong way. This is your logo. This is how it's going to look. This is how you want it to look. So I'm just going to play around with it, size it, position it until it's how I want it to look. And then I'm going to do the same thing to add the last part of my logo, which is by Trisha Denise, my name. And I'm going to just add text again. And I'm going to use that same font, but I'm just going to do it a lot smaller and thinner. I'm not going to make it thick and bold like I did on this one. I'm going to change the color again to pink. And I'm just going to choose one off this color wheel here, because I kind of want a couple of different shades. And once again, I do want it to stand out a little bit. So I'm just going to play around with all the effects, play around with the strokes, see what I like, what I don't like. And like I said, it's all up to how you want your logo to look. So just play around with all the settings until it's how you like it. And I'm sorry about my voice. I'm getting over a cold. I've been sick. So I'm sounding a little hoarse and a little raspy. Sorry about that. So I'm just going to try to position my name where I want it, which I want it next to the word designs, but I wanted it a lot smaller because Bliss Designs, I want that to stand out more. So once I get that how to look how I want it to look, now you can play around with some stickers and clip art and things like that. So you'll go to the bottom and you'll click add sticker. Now here you can type in the search bar what you're looking for. I'm looking for a brush effect, so I'm going to type in brush stroke. And I'm just going to search through. As you can see, there's tons of options, tons of color and pattern options, all sorts of stuff. So like I said, it's totally how you want it to look. You don't have to use any of these. You can search on Google for your own and save it and use that. It's all up to you. So I'm just going to scroll through, and I think I'm going to want to do a gold brush stroke in the back. So I'm just going to scroll. This one looks pretty good. I'm just going to keep looking until I find what I like, and I'm just going to select that brush stroke. I'm going to size it to how big I want it, and I'm going to click those two double squares that's at the top, and then I'm going to click move down again until it's in the back of my logo. And like I said, I'm just going to size it and position it, center it where I want it, and just make everything look how I want it to look. So we're almost done. It's really not difficult. Once you get the hang of it, it's pretty simple. There's really no right or wrong way. It's all up to how you want it to look. Now, I did notice that the gold outline on the word bliss kind of doesn't stand out enough for me because of the gold background. So I am going to change that stroke color to white just so that it can pop a little bit more on that gold. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. And then I'm going to see if I like the way that looks. And then once I'm satisfied, then we're going to do the last step. Now, I like the way that looks with the white outline. It pops a lot more on that gold, and I really like that. So I think I'm pretty satisfied. Excuse my voice, guys. I'm so sorry. So the last step that we're going to do, we have to delete that white box. Remember that we brought in at the beginning. So we're just going to click on the white box, and we're going to click the X in the top left corner and delete that white box from behind it. And that's going to give us the transparent logo, and which is what you want. So when you watermark your work, you'll have a transparent logo. It's not going to have that white box around it. You'll just go to the top right and click next, or click apply and then click next. Click save and download it to your phone, and that is it. That is how you create a logo. So now we're just going to do another one just to kind of go over it again. So once again, go to the bottom, choose the checkerboard, which is the transparent one. Then you're going to click add photo, add that white box again that we saved to our phone earlier, stretch it out over the canvas so we can have a nice space to work with and really see what we're doing. And get it centered and positioned how you want it. So you're going to click add text and type in your first word. Here I'm just making up a random hair company. This is not for anybody. This is just for the purposes of this tutorial. So I'm just going to type the word Lux, and I'm going to make it black just so I can see what I'm doing. I'm going to find a font that I like. So I'm just going to scroll in the fonts until I find something that I like. I know that I want this first word to be pretty big and bold and kind of stand out. So I'm just going to try this font out. I think that's pretty cute. Now I think I want to do a silver glitter. So I'm going to go where it says color, and then I'm going to click add photo, and I'm going to go into my photos, and I'm going to click the silver glitter background that I saved from Google earlier. And that's going to make my letters glitter letters. Now, I think I want to add a stroke to this to make it pop, add some color to it. So I'm going to play around with the colors and the stroke thickness and all that kind of stuff. You can do whatever you want to do. You don't have to have a stroke. You don't have to have glitter letters. You can do a gradient. You can do a solid color. You can leave it black. It doesn't matter. It's all up to you, whatever you want to do. So I'm going to just add a purple stroke here, play around with it. I'm going to add a shadow. Once again, I really like the shadow look because it really makes it pop and make it look like a 3D effect. So I'm just going to play around with that until it looks how I like it to look. Then I'm going to click add text again to add the second word, which is hair. And I'm going to change the color and the font. So I'm just going to make it black so I can see what I'm doing. And I'm going to choose a more fancier font that I like. I didn't see any in my downloads, so I'm going to come to the list of the preset fonts that they already have on here. And I like the way this looks, so I'm going to choose that. But I do want it to pop just a little bit more, so I'm going to go ahead and add a very thin stroke and leave it black just to kind of make the word bold. And then once again, play around with the shadow until it looks how I want it to look. I'm not going to do it too opaque or blurred, I'm going to just kind of have it just a little bit going on in the background, just so it kind of stands out. Then we're just going to repeat this process once again to add the last word on there. You're going to click add text, type in the word. I'm just going to make something up. I'm going to type in by Jasmine. We're just going to pretend that this is Jasmine's hair company. So type in by Jasmine. Of course, I'm going to have to change the color and the font again. Now I'm going to want to do like a really plain, simple font for this one. And I'm going to look for like a bluish purplish kind of color just to keep the brand colors like a purple and blue color theme. And I think I'm going to do a gradient effect here. So I'm going to do blue and purple and just kind of have it be a gradient between the two colors. So I'm just going to play around with this color wheel here until I find the two shades of blue and purple that I want. And I'm going to choose gradient. And then I'm going to change it to the font that I like, which, like I said, I want to do a more simple font. So that's what I'm doing here. You can play around with it, choose what you like, do whatever you want here. And then I'm going to size it how I want it. And I want it pretty small underneath Lux hair, so that it doesn't overpower the first two words. And I kind of like the way that font looks, so I'm going to go with that. Just going to position it and size it where I want it. Once again, this is all up to how you want your logo to look. There's no right or wrong way. So once I size everything how I want it, I'm going to make it just a little bit smaller because now I want to add a picture, like a hair picture on it. So I've already Googled a hair clip art that I saved to my phone. So I'm going to go to the bottom and click add photo, and I'm going to bring that picture in once I get everything placed on here where I want it. So I'm going to add that picture in. You'll notice there's a white background on it, so we need to remove that background. So to do that, you're going to click clip, and it has like the scissors on it. And then you're going to click the little like picture of like a, looks like an outline of a person or whatever. Click that, and that's going to highlight the picture, and it's going to remove the background. And then you just bring it in and size it how you want it, position it how you want it, play around with it until it looks how you want it. So I like the way that looks. Now it still kind of looks kind of plain to me. So now I'm going to play around with some stickers. So once again, you just go to the bottom, you click add sticker, and you can just search for whatever you want. You can go through sparkles, glitter, silver glitter, gold glitter, whatever elements you want. I'm just going to play around with a few things to see how they look. I'm trying out the sparkles and the glitter effect and see if I like the way those look. Like I said, just play around with it, make it how you want it to look. If you're going to do something like this, don't forget you go to the top, click those two boxes, and you're going to click move down, move down, move down as many times as you need to get it behind the logo. I didn't like the way that looked, so I'm coming back looking for something different. Just trying out a couple of different things until I see what I like. And I didn't like the way that looked either, so I'm not going to keep that. So I think I'm going to look for a smoke background, like a smoke effect, and we'll see if we can find a blue and purple smoke effect. So I'm just going to type in smoke in the search bar and see what we come up with. There's tons of options on here. I mean, like so many. And as you can see, there's tons of different colors, shapes, patterns, anything you can think of. So just scroll and look and see what you like, what you don't like. I'm gonna keep scrolling until I find one that I like. And I found a blue and purple smoke that I ended up liking that I'm gonna use. as you can see, there's tons of options. I'm just going to choose this blue and purple one. And once again, click those two squares at the top. Click move down, move down, move down until it's behind all of your different pieces of the logo. So once I get it in the background, I'm just going to size it how I want it, position it where I want it. And I think that looks really cute, except the name at the bottom by Jasmine kind of blends in with that purple smoke a little bit. So I'm just going to click on those words and I'm going to add a stroke, just a small slight stroke. And I'm going to match it up with the blue smoke. So I'm going to give it that same blue color just to make it pop out just a little bit. Just so it doesn't blend in with the purple smoke completely. And I like the way that looks. I'm pretty satisfied. So the last step is to erase that white box once again. So we're just going to click that white square and we're going to click the X in the top left hand corner. And we're just going to take that box away. And now we have a transparent logo. You're going to click apply, then next, save and download. And you have your logo. So that is it. It's really simple. Once you get the hang of it, your options are pretty much unlimited to what you can do on here. You can do a lot of different things, and a lot of the elements are free on Google or different clip art sites that you can download from. So as you can see here, this is what it looks like with the white background. And then we'll show you what it looks like as a transparent logo. It came out really, really cute. I was really satisfied. So yeah, that's pretty much it. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you never miss another video.